Sometimes edible, sometimes precious, often beautiful and inspiring. Crystals, as the basis of the scientific technique crystallography, can also be very useful if you want to find out the structure and shape of things. Easy, you might think, but what if the objects are too small to be seen or touched? What if you want to find out the shape of a protein or a virus? I need a volunteer. Splendid. Step up, please, my little green friend. We're going to find out what shape you are. First, we're going to shrink you down to the size of an average protein. Then, multiply you. Then add you to a solution. Next, we grow a crystal. A dark art. Scientists use robots to control the variables, and even then it can take years for a usable crystal to form. Luckily, I have a secret crystal growing spell. Oh, once the crystal's formed, we barrage it with X-rays. Normally, this involves a trip to a synchrotron. Tonight, however, I am going to use an X-ray gun of my own invention. So we place the crystal on a goniometer so that we can rotate it whilst it's bombarded. The X-rays are diffracted by the crystal and, due to the uniform structure, interference patterns occur, forming clear spots known as reflections. Unfortunately, the crystal is often damaged by the bombardment. But if the spots on the screen are clear enough, then, using the mathematical method of Fourier transformation, I'm sure you've heard of it, the 2D images taken at different rotations can be converted into a 3D model showing the density of electrons. X-ray crystallography has allowed scientists to map the shape of many useful and important structures. Penicillin? DNA? Insulin? Of all the shapes uncovered, though, surely none is more amazing than... Oh, a round of applause for our little green volunteer. Now, who wants to be sawn in half? Goodness, you are a keen one.
Can single crystals really be several metres long? How do you work out a shape from a pattern of spots? Why is the structure and shape of things important anyway? For the latest research to answer all these questions and more, visit www.oxfordsparks.net/crystal.